Joe Biden has named the appointees to his COVID advisory panel, and as promised, they're all public health experts. The co-chairs are Dr. David Kessler, former FDA director under Presidents George H.W. Bush and Bill Clinton, Dr. Vivek Murthy, former Surgeon General under President Barack Obama, and Dr. Marcella Nunez-Smith, from Yale University. 10 other public health experts round out the advisory board. Biden and Kamala Harris received a briefing from the advisory board Monday. Goals for the task force include managing the surge in infections, ensuring vaccines are safe, effective, and distributed efficiently, plus promoting the wearing of masks and social distancing.
I implore you, wear a mask. Do it for yourself. Do it for your neighbor. A mask is not a political statement, but it is a good way to start pulling the country together.
Biden is expected to seek cooperation with state governors to promote masks and social distancing, hoping to move away from President Trump's patchwork approach and create a national plan. Biden's transition team also plans on communicating with Congress to try to push for another round of economic stimulus that would help pay for things like testing and also provide economic relief to individuals, businesses, plus states and local governments. But Biden's transition efforts are being hampered at the moment by the General Services Administration, a U.S. government agency led by a Trump appointee that has yet to formally declare Joe Biden to be the, quote, president-elect. Until that happens, the Biden team won't gain access to federal agencies or the funds set aside to ease the transition from one administration to the next. The Biden transition team is readying a number of executive orders that could be signed by Joe Biden as early as his first day in office. These would undo some key Donald Trump policies, including rejoining the World Health Organization, lifting that partial travel ban on a number of Muslim-majority countries, and eventually rejoining the Paris Climate Agreement. Jim Spellman, CGTN, Wilmington, Delaware.